Oh, hi, Greg Miller from Up at Noon. Print, way of the future. Like these extended interviews with the developers? Then click here to subscribe to start. Every time you subscribe, a child gets his wish. Unfortunately, that child is me. I'm really just an 11-year-old boy who wished to be big. But that fortune-telling machine was a real asshole and made me fat. Careful what you wish for, right? Here's my extended interview with Madden 13's Josh Looman. As I live and breathe, Josh Looman.
What's going on, man?
Not much, Josh. How are you?
Good.
Josh, you're here to talk about that Madden NFL 13. I think you have one of the hardest jobs in the video game industry. Because every year Madden comes out, millions of people buy it, and then they go, oh, it's a roster update, blah, blah, and then you are the villain.
Yeah, I think it's a tough thing that all sports developers have to deal with, but, you know, it's good pressure, it's a good challenge, and we like to rise to the occasion.
Are you rising this year
in
Madden NFL 13?
Yeah, we are. I mean, this is the best Madden that, I mean, I've worked on 8 Maddens now, and this is the greatest Madden I've ever worked on.
Why?
I think we got a lot of huge new changes. I mean, Infinity Engine brings physics to Madden for the first time ever. We also rewrote our entire career mode. So now you can be a coach or a player in the same career mode all in 1 year. I mean, it's the biggest change. We have 85 screens in that mode. Not to mention the fact that we have a brand new commentary team. We've got Connect. We've got tons of stuff. So biggest change I've ever seen.
So do you want to rip your eyes out when you read IGN and people say it's just a roster update? Or rip their eyes out?
I don't want to rip anybody's eyes out. I'm fine. Okay. I enjoy seeing. you know, it's one of those things that comes with the territory. You know, we hope that enough people kind of look and play the game and check it out and understand that, of course, it's not a roster update.
Sure. Now, you're breaking new ground here. I'm not sure if I didn't tell you about this ahead of time because I like to spring things on to, I like to keep you on your toes. This Up at Noon being embedded in the review. So usually I have a guest on. I haven't played the game. It's a preview. I don't know anything about the game. Or I am reviewing the game and I can't talk about the game. But this is going up when I review the game. I like Madden a lot this year. I get to congratulate you.
That's
you did a good job.
Thank
it's one
you.
Of those things for, yeah, give it up. Come on. You know, I've been a big NCAA fan for years, and that's kind of been where I've been going and pouring my time into on the football field. And the reason being the presentation, the feel that I am, you know, the Missouri Tigers. I have, you know, the city of Columbia with me when I rush out on the field. And Madden, I thought, was always somewhat out of sync on that. You know, last year's in particular with, like, it opens with this live-action montage, and there's some dubstep, and then I'm into the season, and it didn't work. But what you did this year is really made Madden this connected experience. It was one all-around package that, you know, looked and felt like real life, like what I'm watching on Sunday, right? Like, we talked about this at lunch that, you know, you have this great commentary team, you have the CBS look to the game, you go in and it feels like what you watch.
Yeah, we want it to be familiar. We want when someone sits down and plays it to make it feel like everything you always see on Sunday. And our creative director, Mike Young, his mantra the entire year was, let's touch everything in the game. Let's fix everything. You know, let's not sort of focus on a couple things and then ignore the rest of the game. So we want it to be really tight, concise, you know, a really solid, strong game.
How impossible is that, though? This guy comes in, he's like, touch everything in the game, and you're like, I have 9 months, MRF-er, and then what do you do?
It's hard. I mean, this is probably the hardest year of my career. In order to pull off something like Connected Careers and the Infinity Engine with physics and gameplay, it's a massive amount of work, and I've got to give all the credit to the team. I mean, they worked really hard. There were a lot of late nights and everything, but we love this game. You know, it's blood, sweat, and tears, and we want to make sure that the greatest game possible comes out every August, and I think this year we've delivered on all accounts.
So now, what happens for you now? Madden's coming out, you know, on Tuesday. The reviews are now posting. You're already, I have to imagine, planning for the next year, if there is one unconfirmed, am I right?
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, is that what it is? Is it immediately back into the hopper to try to make another game?
Yeah, I mean, we're already working. Last week we sat down, started talking about ideas. You know, this is kind of a mode that I've pitched for about 3 years now, and Mike really got on board.
Connected
and,
Careers?
Connected Careers, okay. Yeah.
And what is that for somebody just tuning in who hasn't read the review yet? Come
on. Yeah, so it's basically a brand new career mode that combines online franchise, offline franchise, and superstar modes. You can be a player or a coach in the same league. Online, 32 users, you can play 30 years. It's got all the features you've ever wanted in franchise mode. So, we're starting to talk about next year already. The problem with having a short cycle and having to put out a game every year is you have to get started early and you have to hit the ground running. So we are. I dream about ideas for Madden, so I'm trying to get that out of my head right now. No, I wish. A dream catcher. Yeah, that'd be nice. You know, we're working hard, so.
So do you like that kind of turnaround? Is it one of those things like in a perfect world, did you wish that Madden wasn't annualized, that Madden was you're going to put out a Madden when you're ready to put out a Madden?
I think I'm used to it. You know, I've been doing this for 10 years now, and every year there's this intensity all the time where you're trying to make sure that everything you get in the game is awesome. you get finished with the game, you're ready to ship it, you start working on next year and everything. You know, sometimes you look at games that have like a 7-year development cycle and you just kind of think, I can't imagine what we could do in 7 years with what we can do in 9 months a lot of the time. So, you know, someday we may get to that point. I think that would be great. But right now, I think we're set up pretty well for knocking it out every year.
I mean, is it ever detrimental, though? Do you worry about it? Because we talk about, you know, like, it's a roster update. And sometimes, you know, you make this awesome connected career, and then I'm assuming next year around it won't be as brand new, right? It's not going to be this giant fresh take on connected career, but you'll tweak this and you'll change that. And then it feels like you have to fight this uphill battle, right, to get people to be, you know, not dismissive of it.
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, you know, the true fans always kind of hang on every word and are waiting for all the information and want to know what's going on and everything. And, this year was definitely a foundation year. It was, you know, trying to get core changes to gameplay in, trying to get this huge new career mode in and make sure that they were able to be so solid we could build on them in the future. So, you know, next year we've already got a list of ideas that we really want to change those things and take them to the next level. So I think we've got tons of ideas. It's just getting enough time to put them in.
Sure. Talk a little bit about now. We talked about the Infinity Engine here, physics for the first time in Madden. What does that mean? Before it wasn't like I was throwing the ball and it was drifting off into space.
Yeah, I mean, the big thing is before when we recorded animations for tackles and that kind of stuff, when you had a tackle on a running play, you'd see the same tackle every other play. So it kind of felt a little artificial. It didn't really feel as much like what you'd see on Sunday on TV. So with the new Infinity Engine, there's a different outcome to every single play. When somebody gets tackled, you're going to see somebody spin off. You know, I've seen plays where a running back was running down the field and there was a defender holding onto his ankle and he was dragging him and he like kicked him off and took off running. And it's just different on every single play. And it makes it so that it feels much more organic and dynamic all the time. So it's a drastic change. If you've played Madden in the past, to play now and look at it and go, wow, I've never seen anything like that before.
Is that something you think you'll be honing in on for next year? I mean, is there more to do? Is that something you added and you were so happy with it, but now you're like, oh, well, wait a second?
Yeah, I think everything can be improved at all times. I know there's a lot of other gameplay stuff that we'd like to touch on. Our GM of football, Cam Weber, came down from Fight Night and FIFA. He worked on those at EA. And his emphasis when he came down, which I think is awesome, was all about gameplay. You know, that's the crux of our mode of Madden in general, is to get in, focus on gameplay, make it as solid as possible, and then build great features around that. But, you know, I've always said I've worked on career modes for years, for franchise mode and superstar. If gameplay is not great, nobody cares about franchise mode. So getting those things to be awesome. And I know that, you know, improving physics, taking it to the next level, and also focusing on the rest of gameplay, you know, that kind of stuff. I think that's the key.
Was it hard to get RPG stuff into Madden? I mean, that's one of the big things about this year, right? Is that if I'm being a coach or if I'm being a player, I'm going out into practices and I'm earning XP and then, you know, making my character or my team better. Was there ever pushback to that? I mean, we're a football game.
You know, tiny bit. You know, it's actually, there's a lot of us that are really hardcore football guys. And, you know, most of us only play sports games. You know, we obsess about the NFL and the NBA and Major League Baseball and that kind of stuff. But believe it or not, we have a lot of people that work on our team, programmers, artists, that kind of thing, that aren't necessarily the biggest football fans, just like you guys have people here at IGN that aren't necessarily the biggest football fans. So I think it was great to focus on some of those things and bring in core elements from the games that they really love that helped energize them and got them really into working on it. And, you know, a lot of the time, there's so many concepts in football that if you don't like football, you don't understand them. With this kind of stuff, they'd look at it and go, I get that. I understand that. That's Skyrim or, you know, that kind of stuff. It's very similar. So I think that helped us in a lot of ways.
Are those key to, I mean, not burning out and not getting stuck in a rut? I mean, we, you know, like I was saying, a lot of jokes on the internet about Madden being in a rut, but you guys do bring in the stuff and you do different stuff, but it would be easy just to sit back and put out, you know, well, here's Tom Brady's new stats and here's this new running back.
Yeah, I think it might be easy, but we'd be doing a disservice to ourselves and to the game and to the NFL. You know, from my perspective as a designer, I'm always like trying to think of new ideas. So you play every game on the market. I may prefer playing sports games, but I'm going to play the hell out of Skyrim and play everything I can so that I see what other people are doing. I appreciate what other people are doing and take those core concepts and figure out a way if there's a way to apply them to a football game. It doesn't, you know, a football game doesn't always have to be just exactly what's in the NFL. You can take those concepts and still make it a video game. So I think it's really important to remember that as a designer and kind of apply those concepts.
Now, I know you're happy to be gainfully employed, so this, I swear, isn't a trick question. Do you wish there was more competition in the football video game space? I mean, you go out and you play everything. You play every other sports game. Do you wish there was someone else out there making football? And I know we've tried with Backbreaker and things like this, but...
Yeah, I mean, you know, I was around back in the days when we did have competition. I think there's advantages and disadvantages to both scenarios. I think anybody that loves sports always likes being competitive, and I really appreciated the days when we'd kind of go head-to-head with 2K5, but I also like the relationship we've got with the NFL now. It's really great to be able to get access to all the plays, all the footage, you know, talk to the NFL all the time and kind of work through concepts with them and everything. So there's pros and cons to everything, but you know, either way is definitely something that I've been involved with and I'm fine with.
You seem fine with everything. Yeah. You're very even keeled.
I'm pretty, like, yeah, I'm an easygoing guy.
10 years, Madden, no big deal.
Yeah, whatever.
Whatever, let's go play. Any chance of you ever getting an XFL license out there? I really want an XFL game. And they were working on one a long time ago.
I don't know, man.
Come on.
I don't know. Sure.
All right, good, thanks.
Possibly, maybe, no, who knows.
Well, there you go, that's a glimmer of hope. That's all Greg Miller ever needed. Before we wrap up, I got some Twitter questions for you.
Yep.
But the big thing for me, talk a little bit about this year. It didn't come together. PlayStation Vita's out. PlayStation 3's out. Connected Career, though, from what I learned at preview events, too complicated, too expansive at the moment with everything you're trying to do with online, offline, XP, you know, blah, 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 to come to Vita. Is that something you guys are looking at, you think, for the future, one day, possibly, maybe? To be able to take my save on the road, put it back up?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the theme of Connected Careers is obviously being connected. We've got a website, you know, we've got a tie-in with real Twitter, with Facebook groups, that kind of stuff. So I don't know if there's any concrete plans at this point, but it's something that we'll definitely look into in the future and make sure that the mode itself is always connected in every way that you can connect it. So that, you know, we want people to not have to just turn off the console and go, well, my experience is over.
Yeah.
You can either be on the console, you can be on the website, that kind of stuff. So I think the sky's the limit going forward for ideas in that space.
What about Madden going forward in general? I mean, it's one of those things. I was talking to somebody last night and I was telling them why I like the game and why I think it works for me, and we've set up a Madden date and we're being all really weird about it. But what we're talking about is, like, you know, how you get going, but then by November it seems like Madden's burned out. And you guys are going this extra step this year to try to make that not happen, right? Like, what are you doing?
Yeah, I mean, we've done a lot of stuff in Connected Careers where we want to really focus on replayability. So you can play a season as a tight end in a league with 10 of your buddies. If, you know, you start getting bored as a tight end, you can quit in that league without starting anything over. You can come back as a coach or a quarterback and keep going in the same league with all your buddies. So replayability is a big deal. We're also supporting the game as long as we can this year. So, you know, we've talked about some patches. We can update tuning data for Connected Careers on the server if you're online, that kind of stuff. So we've built a lot of tools that make sure that we're going to support Madden 13 as long as we can.
You know, we always talk about that, you know, digital's the future here of video games, blah, blah. And granted, we're just talking out our ass. It's video game journalism. Nobody knows what they're saying. But let's say it was. Would you be looking forward to a day where there was, like, basically like a Madden MMO platform kind of thing? You know, I mean, I know we're just two dudes. We're not CEOs of EA.
Yeah.
We're not spitballing
right,
here.
Right.
But, you know, where you'd have a subscription and you'd be getting these modes, and, like, there wouldn't be maybe necessarily this big release, but there'd be, like, kind of like, you know, World of Warcraft expansion packs or something like that.
Yeah, I know a lot of the fans have talked about that. I know EA as a whole is really trying to focus on going digital in the future. So
Origin, sign up now.
Yeah. So it's definitely something that, you know, pretty far down the road I could see possibly happening. I know I would be excited about that. It would be kind of a different way of developing. And, you know, if we can get to that point, awesome. Until then, we will put out the best product we can every single year.
All right. I like that. Let's see what the Twitter quiz are asking.
All
remember,
right.
Ladies and gentlemen, follow me at GameOverGreggy. I will tweet who's on the show, like Josh here. And then you tweet at me the questions, then I read them here on the air, and you get your name on the internet, and you go, man, I love the internet. All right, well, this one comes from Jeff. Jeff says, what do you say to criticism that Madden cares more about how it looks than how it plays?
I think, you know, this year more than any other year, we've tried to really focus on gameplay. You know, the Infinity Engine's huge. We've fixed passing trajectories. We've fixed defense. You know, no longer do you have DBs or linebackers that when the ball's in the air and it's over there, they just kind of swat at it and knock it down without ever even seeing it. Playing the game is vital to keeping people around and the replayability of it. So in Connected Careers, Infinity Engine, all that stuff, we're more focused right now on making sure that the gameplay experience is so tight and concise that, that would be my answer. You know, I'm much more focused on how it plays than how it looks.
Yeah, it plays well, don't worry. Read about it on IGN.com.
Thank you.
All right, one final question here comes from Connor. This question is for Madden NFL. That's you. He says, the so-called Madden curse, does the development team believe in it as well as the cover athletes? Do you believe in the Madden curse?
You know,
of course, the Madden curse, if you're on the cover of Madden, something bad's going to happen.
I think it's a great story all the time.
Yeah.
People love to talk about it, which is always a good thing.
Yeah, I'm sure you love Madden being talked about.
Yeah, that's never a bad thing. I think it really kind of, you know, raises some debate sometimes and discussion about that. I think the athletes like to talk about it, so I think it's a great thing. I'm a huge Detroit Lions fan. Megatron's my favorite player, so this year I do not want it to come true.
You do not believe in it this
year? No, not at all.
All right.
If Detroit loses Megatron, we're done.
Yeah. Or if you run up against my Chicago Bears, huh, yeah. Jay Cutler?
There you go.
All right. Josh, thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you.
No problem. Thank you for watching that extended interview with Madden 13's Josh Looman. Did you like what you saw? Then subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment below. My favorite drinking game is making it through the day.